Hey there, Econ students. In this video, we'll be looking at how to create a CPI, a consumer price index, and also how to find inflation. So while watching this video, make sure to use the guided notes. You can find the guided notes in the description below. The guided notes go along with the video and it'll help you understand the content better. So let's just start talking about CPI, a consumer price index. We're going to cover this first and then we'll get into inflation. Now, a consumer price index is used to kind of see what's happening with inflation. Now, we're going to have a base year for this. When we're looking at inflation, we have to understand that the value of money changes over time. And when we have inflation, that means our purchasing power is going down. So a consumer price index is used to kind of see what's going on with inflation with a certain basket of goods. Normally, we'll have the same goods compared in a CPI every single year. So that way we can see how the value of those goods has changed. If those goods cost more, we've seen inflation. If they've cost less, then we might see deflation occurring. To calculate this out, we first have to create a CPI. First thing we'll have to do is select a base year. That's step one. Step two is we'll need to actually select what's going to be in our basket of goods. Step three, we'll record all of the different prices for each of our years. And then we'll times that by the quantity. So we'll be able to see exactly how much our basket costs. Step four is the math part. Now, before you freak out about math, it isn't that bad. We're going to use this formula. Our CPI will equal the current value of our market basket. So this is referencing whatever year we're trying to find. And then we're going to divide it by the base year. Now, I've already referenced the base year, but a base year is going to be the year that we're going to use that value. This value, whatever our base year is that we decide to pick, that is going to then be the value that we'll compare of our money to all the other years. After dividing, we times it by 100, and this is going to get our CPI. Now, this isn't necessarily a percent, it's an index number. But it does show us a percent change compared to just the base year. Not between year to year, but it shows what's happened with the value of money in comparison to our base year. So let's actually look at this in practice and kind of see what we're talking about. It's easier to visualize it when we're actually seeing the numbers firsthand. So over here right now, you can see I have a couple different years. I have 2014 all the way to 2019. Now, one of the important things to realize here is we've selected this base year at 2015. Now, what this means is this is the year I'm going to use to compare that value of the basket to everything else. One thing to note, the CPI for the base year will always be 100. Every single time, the base year will be 100. Remember that. And the reason why is if I'm looking at the value, if I'm trying to calculate out what's happening with our CPI, I'm going to use the formula we talked about earlier. I'm going to take the current value of the market basket and divide it by the base year. Well, if I'm talking about the base year, I'm dividing the same thing by itself. So for here, I'd be taking 25 divided by 25. That's going to give me 1. And then I would times it by 100. So my base year is 100, the CPI 100. Now, try to figure out what the CPI would be for all the other years. Remember the formula. The formula is our current market basket, whatever year we're trying to find, divided by the base year market basket, and times that by 100. Pause this video and try to figure it out. Did you get it? Check your answers right now. You can see the answers on the screen. One of the things to note is when we're looking at this, we're not seeing the inflation rate between every single year. We're seeing it in comparison to our base year. So for example, if I'm looking at 2016, I have a CPI of 120. That means I've had 20% inflation since my base year. If I look at 2017, I can see it's 160. This means that I've had a 60% inflation rate from the base year, not from 2016. The next thing we're going to go into is actually how to find an inflation rate between years. This is, again, just showing us what's happening between the base year with inflation. Hopefully the CPI is making sense, how to find it. It isn't too bad. It's just important to understand the formula and what's going on. One other thing to note is if we're ever going below 100 now, like we can see for 2014, we're actually seeing deflation. Our value is going the opposite way. Instead of inflation occurring where we're losing purchasing power, we're actually seeing it where we're gaining purchasing power. Our money is worth a little bit more. So that's something to consider. Now, let's go on to the next thing where we'll actually look at how to find the inflation rate between 2 years. So when calculating out the inflation rate between 2 years, we're going to use the following formula. We're going to have our year two minus year one divided by year one times it by 100. That's it. Now, this is important to understand. When looking at a problem, you have to have the previous year to be able to find the inflation rate between 2 years. So let's take a second and look back at the data that we just calculated out for our CPI. You can see here we have, again, 2014 to 2019. One of the things to note here, if we wanted to find the inflation rate between years, we actually can't for 2014. The reason why is we don't have the data for 2013, so we wouldn't be able to solve that. However, let's go and do one together, and then we'll see if you can figure out the rest of the table. Let's calculate out the inflation rate for 2015. So we're looking from 2014 to 2015. What we're going to do here is take our 100, which is going to be our year two. That's the current year we're trying to figure out what happened. We're going to minus it by the 60 because that's our CPI for year one. Then we'll divide it by 60. We're then going to times our answer by 100, which will turn it into a percent. So we're going to have 66.6667, it's kind of repeating, percent. That would be our inflation rate between these 2 years. Is it making sense? Try to figure out the rest of the table. I'll leave the formula up there, but use our CPI that we calculated out before to find the inflation rate between each of these years. Good luck. Pause the video now. Hopefully you're able to figure it out. If you need more time, pause the video. Right now you can see the answers here. Again, this is showing us the inflation rate between our 2 years. It's important to remember that we're always going to take year two minus year one and divide by year one. Hopefully this is starting to make sense. It isn't too bad. The math is not that hard. It's just important to remember the formulas and what to do with it. Now, I know this was a really quick overview. The goal of this video was just to kind of quickly show how to find a CPI and also calculate out the inflation rate. I hope it helped. If this video helped you out, please subscribe and support the channel and check out some of the other videos on it. I'm Mr. Sinn. Thanks for watching the video, and until next time, I'll see you online.